welcome back. A nice shot from the CN Tower. CN Tower cam live for you right now as we are hosting live from our studios here at 622 College Street in the heart of Little Italy in Siena con Grace. Ciao, Grace.
Sembra che c'è il sole e non è così oggioso oggi.
We're looking up
at the skylight, by the way, if you're wondering.
Where are they looking? We have a skylight, a really big skylight in our
atrium.
That's the word I was looking for. I was going to say auditorium. It's atrium. So we talked a little bit with Emily Richards today about what to bring to our table, but we're also now returning our attention to sweets, I dolci.
Food.
That's right. And please welcome us back. It's been a while. Please welcome Tony from La Strada Bakery.
Buona domenica, Tony.
Buona domenica.
Tony,
how's everyone doing over there?
We are great, Tony. And you know what? Thank you again for joining us. Before we talk about what you are going to present for us right now, let's talk a little bit about COVID and business and your establishment. Local businesses right now have been under, of course, a lot of pressure, but you've been, you're doing what you do best. Talk to us about this experience with you and your business.
Well, it is very difficult during these times, right? You have to navigate with your staff and all the protocols, and which is the easy part, the protocols, because we've always kept a very clean and sterile place. But you know, some of the staff, you know, they were worried at the beginning, and people were, you know, waiting outside, and it took time for everybody to get used to the new way of business, right? It is very difficult. We've had to make a lot of cuts on staff, on everything, but you know, we keep going, and every day is a new struggle, but we get through it. And now the holidays are coming, and we're hoping that people still get together with their families a little bit, right?
So to that point, Tony, so have your clients been very still dedicated to you guys and still supporting you in every way?
Our clients have, yes. So they want our product. Now, we run an old school bakery, so everything is done differently, and we're small. We're only letting a few people in the store at a time, so they feel safe when they come here, and that's the main thing.
And to that point, you know, Tony, you talk about like a traditional way of doing what you do. Your La Strada has been known and has been within the Vaughan community for a long time. Can you give us a little brief history of La Strada Bakery?
Well, my parents actually started in 1961, and I took over this location about 16 years ago. So this is the second generation. We've been doing this for quite a long time.
Adesso passiamo ai dolci. Let's go to the sweets. They look so wonderful. If you want to start to show us where to begin on this beautiful table.
Well, you know, we have bake at home products that people like to bake at home. A lot of people with the COVID, they felt safe baking their own products at home. So we have like little mini apple blossoms. And for the people for Thanksgiving, that's a great idea. You know, we have little pumpkin shortbread cookies that we pack individually. So, you know, if you want to give them away to their grandkids or whatnot, you know, they're already packaged and nobody touches them. And for the people who don't want your traditional apple and pumpkin, we also do like a Nutella square, which is like a mini pie, but filled with Nutella. And those are our frozen products. Just a few of our frozen products. As for our pies, these are just a few of them as well, your classic apple. But what we are known for is our pumpkin pie, which we make from scratch, our own puree, which is not just pumpkin. It's pumpkin, it's squash, it's sweet potato. It's just 35% cream in it. So it's truly something different that you haven't tried, you should.
So you're sharing your secrets to your pumpkin pie. Is that all the ingredients, or did you miss one? Because I'm taking notes.
Well, there's quite a few spices and a few other little things that we won't let everybody know.
What is your favorite? What is the most popular pie?
Our pumpkin pie is actually the most popular because it's something totally different than anywhere else. And I would say next to that is our apple, which is your classic.
So let me ask you something, Tony. You know, you know how to bake a pie. You know how to bake a good crust. The crust is always the biggest issue. Can you give us a tip on how to make that perfect crust? What are we doing wrong? How do we get that flaky is the word I'm looking for. Thanks, Grace. Crust.
Well, the problem with crust is it's very gentle. A lot of people will overmix their crust. Mm-hmm. Once you overmix it, you start to build the gluten and it becomes rubbery and tough. It doesn't become tender anymore. So your crust really needs to be mixed very little, and it's a gentle process.
So I know you're going to be, I think you have, you're going to, I guess, plate some. I mean, unfortunately, we can't taste your food, but I know you're going to, you know, share some. You're going to cut a couple on how to plate it, how to plate one of your pies, right? You're going to do that for us right now so we can kind of see the finished product. And as you do that, Tony, as you do that, let's talk again, reminding us more than ever why we need to support local.
Well, we need to support local for the reasoning. Local supports a lot of people's jobs, right? And people are missing out on work. Like, I have a few people that I haven't called back yet because financially we just can't. So these people, you know, I feel bad for them because they also have families at home. And if we're not supporting our own local businesses, we're supporting foreign businesses, we're never going to really get out of all this.
So absolutely.
But I also believe local is actually even much more fresh. Like, I mean, you can buy pies, but they're like, you know, mass produced in a factory. But it's wonderful that your family recipe, it's basically like mom made. So I think that is important, and that's a difference.
I wish we could try your pie, Tony.
Well, you know what? I think through the magic of television, we can.
Oh my goodness,
Tony.
Thank you.
Lenny, are you jealous, Lenny? Because this is your favorite pumpkin pie, Lenny.
Tony, I have to tell you, you really are fantastic.
Wow.
I mean, come on, the magic of television. You're a magician too.
His arms are very long.
They are very long. So
grazie, Tony.
We're going to taste this, Tony. I'm going to take the first bite here. Tony Lastrada's famous pumpkin pie.
That is incredible. I have never had, this is a very different, it's pumpkin pie, but there's a lot of other secret ingredients in here. Oh, delicious.
Thumbs up, Tony.
Yes,
thumbs
up. It's all from scratch, so it's totally different.
And the crust is just flaky and moist, though.
So, Tony, I want to thank you. I know that you were busy at work today on a Sunday afternoon, always working. Thank you for some great tips, and I really want to stress it again. We say to all of our viewers, get out there, support local. La Strada Bakery, a great place within the city of Vaughan for many, many, many years.
Si, grazie, Tony, and happy Thanksgiving to you, your family, and the staff at La Strada.
Thank you for having us. Happy Thanksgiving to everyone, and stay safe.
Grazie.
Grazie. Cheers to you. This was good.
This is definitely,
really good.
You know what, there are ingredients in here. I got to figure it out. I got to deconstruct
that?
I have to deconstruct this. I have to have my pumpkin pie aficionado there tell me what's different about this pie.
Well, you know what, Tony was very gracious. He shared a nice pumpkin pie for you there, Lenny. So you'll have to tell us what you think.
So, Andrea, adesso andiamo un po' di pubblicità.
That's
e noi mangiamo.
Cheers.